to cast on with your bond machine and using the black hem, first of all, you're going to bring out what needles to hold in position. If you want to, you could put the green card behind the needles to hold them in place. Eventually, you'll learn not to use those. Then you're going to take your black hem and hang it over the needles. Then you're going to take, they send you elastic. Now, that's good to start out with, but you probably want to change to a ravel cord, some nylon cord that's thin enough it'll work through the carriage. Well, it doesn't have to be too thin. Crochet, this is crochet cotton. This is the thinner stuff. I have used the thicker crochet cotton, or even some fishing line. As long as it's something that's slippery that will work through the carriage. Then you're going to, of course you have to use something to open up your latches before you lay the thread on there. Then you take your black hem and bring it down over the work. And then they have you bring, and you want to be careful because you want to try to keep those latches in the hooks, I mean the thread in the hook. Now, if you accidentally get it behind the latches, just go ahead and push the needles forward with the work behind the open latches here. Then take and push your needles back, either having your yellow card on the machine. You want to make sure all your latches are open too. You don't want them to close. And slowly push them to where the latch touches that. And as you see that latch is starting to close, I go back so that it lays open. And then you're going to start knitting with your waist yarn. You do need to put some kind of clamp or clothespin on the ends. And I like taking the two ends, if they're long enough, and just rolling it between my fingers to twist them. And then take one clamp or clothespin. That way, I'm not using two clothespins. And that's only to hold that in place. I do need to put a clamp on the end of the yarn. And then I just start knitting away. Now what you want to do is you're going to hold the yarn until that first needle catches. Then you can let it go, or you can hold it if you want. I kind of put my thumb right here and let the yarn slip underneath my thumb at times. Other times, I have one hand on the carriage, the other hand holding the yarn above it. Now, I'm done with my waist yarn, and I need to cut it. And I can pull that through. I take the clamp off of the first yarn, I put it on the end of that one. And I want to knit another row of ravel cord. I cut at the other end. And I need to put a clamp on both ends of this ravel cord. But what I like to do next is to do an E-wrap cast on. So I push the needles forward. I am going to, well, the needles are in holding position, so I could go ahead and just slide my carriage across. And now I need to get my main yarn and start doing an E-wrap or crochet cast on. It's up to you, really. Now, if you have the older ISM or one of the carriages that has the wire on the front of it, it's best to put the yarn through the carriage first, but if not, you could remove the wire and thread it in there. So now, the way I do an E-wrap is I start from left to right because I'm right-handed. You could start from right to left if you're left-handed. There's no rule in that. Even though a pattern tells you have carriage on right, you could start it with carriage on left. You're not breaking any laws. So anyways, I hold the yarn underneath the needles with my left hand. I take that yarn, I come up between the next two empty needles, and I go down between to the left of that needle. And when you look at it, it looks like you're doing an E. That's why they call it an E wrap. Now, you don't want to do this too tight, but you don't want to have it too loose either. And in time, you will get to see what you need to do when casting on this way. Now, if you're doing the latch toll cast on, after you get the next to the last needle here with the loop over it, you just take the last loop, put it on the end needle, and you're all set. So now I like to push my cast on to the back of the bed. I take my cut credit card. I make sure that all these needles are open. With the bond machine, you do have to do that. Other machines, you don't really have to. Then again, just using my finger, I push the needles back to the forward working position, and it's just as the yarn is starting to close. Of course, you could use your yellow cards again. And you just start knitting again. I've always liked to make my yarn cakes when working on the knitting machines. Now, if you have that, or even a skein yarn, you could lay it on its side like this. If it doesn't pull out freely, you need to pull a whole bunch out for each row until that comes out freely. And then you could just let it pull from the yarn cake. Okay, so something's wrong here. Let me see. There we go. So again, you're going to hold the yarn until it catches on the first needle and start knitting. Now, sometimes this end needle doesn't work for me. What I'm going to do is just undo it so I have one last needle. Now, with the needles in working position, it doesn't matter if the latches are closed. It will knit proper. It should knit properly for you. You do need to understand that this machine can be a little finicky. A lot of people do have problems with this machine. But in time, you'll learn how to control it. Patience is a virtue, one step at a time, and you can make beautiful items on this machine as you can with any metal bed machine or electronic machine. Of course, you're going to have to do more hand manipulation on this, but really, you know, if you're not into doing a whole bunch of tuck stitches or ferrule and you want to do just plain stockinette stitch, this could be the machine for you. Now, sometimes you need to have an extra weight, and it's best if you had a claw weight. You could take a fork. I believe I paid like a dollar for 6 of these at Walmart, and then you bend them so that they will resemble a claw weight. And then you could hang a fishing weight on here somehow to give it more weight if needed. Now, I've been able to use just these for doing a short row circular blanket. But when you start noticing these end stitches are not knitting properly, you do need to get some weight on there. The original machines come with a couple S hooks and an elastic that does the same thing. So you could use that until you could get a hold of some claw weights or make your own fork weights.